In the last video, I showed you how to make gorgeous websites that no one else can by using 3D Gaussian splatting. In this video, I want to show you how you can hook into your Gaussian splat with JavaScript, which will allow you to create insane 3D experiences, such as the wobbly 3D floor and color-changing fog that you've seen in this video. You can also use JavaScript to hand over control of your 3D scene to your site's visitors. Imagine 3D scanning an environment, uploading it to your site as a Gaussian splat, and then allowing your users to interact and play with that environment. Before we start coding, I want to outline what we'll be doing. In the last video, the way we put a Gaussian splat on our website was with a simple embed, which you can do using the iframe or embed link that Luma AI provides for you. However, Luma also provides a JavaScript SDK, which allows you to create a rendering of a Gaussian splat programmatically and add it to your site. This splat object that you now have access to in your code gives you a lot more control over the splat than a simple embed. Now, in this video, I want to focus on the Luma Web library. To facilitate this, I'm going to use Wix, which is perfect for the situation, but we'll take a few setup steps. If some other setup is more convenient to you, you can skip this part until where I start writing some code. Let's start by visiting wix.com.
Create new site, start from a blank canvas.
Let's turn developer mode on. Now click embed and social on the left and custom element. Now we want the custom element to take up this whole area. So with the custom element selected, we go to the size section on the right, click on the three dots, and we can add advanced sizing. This allows us to change the width to 100% and the height to 100% as well. Now we have to choose the source. So you can either host your elements code at some URL of your choice, or we can create a new Velo file, which is what I'm going to do here. Let's see the file that was created for us. So we can click on these squiggly brackets on the left, public and backend, and you can see that a custom elements directory was created for us with our JavaScript code under it. Over here, you can see a bunch of code that we get by default in our custom element. But for our purposes, let's just delete all of that. Now, obviously, we're going to need the Luma Web package, so let's install that from NPM. And Wix has an easy way to do that. Just go to packages and apps, install package from NPM, and we're going to look for Luma Web and click install. So this is the Luma Web library, which I highly recommend checking out. You can visit that URL right over there. Over here, you can see that we're going to need a WebGL renderer, a perspective camera, and a scene that we're going to get from Three.js. Now, the Three.js package is available via NPM, and Wix makes it really easy to install any NPM package that you want on your site. We're going to jump to packages and apps, and then install packages from NPM. And then I'm just going to search for three. On the left, we get some information. On the right, there's additional information about the package. If the latest version is not compatible with your site, maybe because of some other packages that you have installed, you can actually right-click and choose a different version, not the latest one. By default, it will install the latest version, and just click install. After the packages download, they'll show up on the sidebar under packages and apps. And over here, you can see that Luma Web and 3 have both been downloaded, and we are ready to start coding. So let's go back to our custom element code. I could write import Luma 3. I'm just going to copy and paste that. Over here, there's this code in Wix IDE button, which is a cloud-based IDE, VS Code-based. So this is pretty sweet. And this VS Code style IDE synced automatically with Wix Studio, like over here. This stuff is what we got to import from 3. All right. Okay, so now we could do let render equal new WebGL renderer. Okay, and what I don't like about this is that I'm not getting GitHub Copilot completions. So in the next video, I'll show you how to turn that on. But first, let's get this working. Now, for performance reasons, we're supposed to put anti-alias false. You know what? I want Copilot completions. So let's just do that now. So I'm going to switch back to the editor, and you can see right over here, everything was updated, and it's not going to let me connect to it right now because the IDE is still open. So let's go to the Wix IDE and leave it. And now I can connect this to GitHub. You should read that. Okay, and let's name this YouTube Splat. And I'm not going to give it a description. We have to install the Velo app
application. I have to confirm, verify my identity. Okay. And over here, we can just install it on the our repository that we just created. And here are our instructions. I already have the Wix CLI, so I'm not going to install that. I just need to install these. So I'm going to copy that. Open Warp. Okay. Let me back out of where I am to my general project directory. So let's just run all of that. So creating that project and CDing into it, installing all the dependencies. Now, don't worry about this error. There's a conflict between Luma Web, the version of 3 that it depends on, and the 3 that I installed separately. We can ignore it for now, maybe forever. Let's open this directory in VS Code. Okay, and we need a camera. So let's do let camera equal new perspective camera. And this is great. Now I have Copilot. So that's awesome. And Copilot's absolutely correct. Let scene equal new scene. What's next? Oh, we also need controls. So let's do let controls equal new orbit controls. Controls enable damping true. Controls damping factor 25. Why not? I'm just accepting these at this point. Okay, we do have to import orbit controls. So you see how good it is that I was able to sync my Wix site code with my local IDE, because now I can get GitHub Copilot or whatever local LLM I'm running. And now the most important part, equal new 3. So you don't have to do it this way. You don't have to use the URL. And I actually want to test it out if you host the Splat yourself. If you host it yourself, so then you can use that as the source. It doesn't need to be the URL. I don't know if there's a difference in terms of quality, speed, or anything like that. And now, of course, we're going to do scene.adds. That's interesting. It's suggesting a camera position. But let's just do this. Renderer.okay. And now we just need to create our class. Let's say splat element extends HTML element. We need to implement connected callback. We'll just do this append child. Renderer DOM element. And now we define the tag for the custom element. So in the terminal, I'm just going to do Wix dev. That's going to open up a local editor, which is synced with our local code. Let's look at the source for the custom element. We could see the tag name is Hello World. So we could either change it there or here. What did we call it? Luma Splat. Let's call this Luma Splat. Lastly, we need to do render set animation loop. And something like that. And that's basically just, we also want to do, let's get the canvas so that we can get the width and the height. So if the width or the height changes, we can re-render the scene. Okay, now we could save that. Okay, so let's pop over to the terminal and we'll do Wix dev. Okay, and now it's serving our local files with our local changes in the local version of the Wix editor. Let's check if our code is here. Yep, it's all here. Let's hit run. And there we are. So here I didn't yet set any movement or anything like that, but even though this looks like an image, if you click on it, you can see that it is actually our 3D scene. And this is already really cool. One thing is that in order to see this element live on the site, you do need a premium plan. And now we could do Wix preview and we'll preview local code. And there we go. We could visit that link. Boom. And here is our wonderful Gaussian splat. And if we like that, we can go and do Wix publish. Again, we're going to publish the local code. And yes, I'm going to ignore that warning. And we can visit our site live. And you can actually visit this URL. It's now live. And we're done. So that's the basics of putting a Gaussian splat on your site with code. In the next couple of videos, I'll show you how to do all the fancy stuff.